Hello there, I'm Tansir Saji and you're watching Data Compression 101. Today we'll learn about one of the first compression techniques used in modern computer science as fast as possible. It was the year 1948 when mathematician and electrical engineer Claude Shannon published his research entitled A Mathematical Theory of Communication. The technique Shannon proposed in his research introduced the field of information theory and was attributed to Robert Fano when he later published it as a technical report. And this officially marked the birth of Shannon Fano Coding. Shannon Fano Coding at its core is a five-step process. List, sort, divide, label, repeat. List the given symbols and probabilities or frequency counts. Then sort this frequency distribution in descending order or from most probable symbol to least probable symbol. After that, divide this sorted list into two parts such that the sum of probabilities of each part is almost similar. Then, label the left part of the list as 0 and the right part of the list 1. Finally, recursively divide and label until no further divisions can be made. Let's try to understand this algorithm with an example. Consider Mississippi. The first part of the algorithm says to list the symbols or letter with their probability of occurrence, which mathematically is the frequency of that letter divided by the sum of all frequencies. Step 2 says to arrange the list in descending order of their probability. Now divide this sorted list into two parts such that sum of probabilities of each part is almost similar. After that, label left part as 0 and right part as 1 and finally, repeat until no further divisions can be done. Hence, we have encoded Mississippi just like we've done in Huffman coding. Click the I button to watch that video. The link to the IPython notebook is in the description. There is a bug in the code. Your today's coding challenge is to find that bug and write the corrected code in your choice of language and post your GitHub link in the comments. Winners will be announced in the next video. There are so many methods of data compression. Subscribe if you haven't already and click that bell icon to get notified every time I upload a video in this series called Data Compression 101. If you are not sure why you should be learning data compression, watch the video on left, and if you want to see the entire series click the video on the right and make sure to leave a like and also comment.